with the Quran. Allah says in the Quran, I give life and I cause death. God is taking credit for both life and death. What does that mean? That the Creator, when He created everything, put a time on it. Everything in creation has a time. And nothing in creation remains forever except God. Everything must die. Now, all of us came on the planet with expectations, of course. You know, life means you want to hold on. When you got life, Jack, you don't want to die if you got sense.
Say, well, they ain't going to give you nothing.
You're right. They ain't going to know nothing. Some of us don't know nothing now. It's like we already did. Family, look. Life is the most precious of all the gifts that God gives. If you protect it, if you strive to preserve it by living in accord with the law of life, then death will come when you can ward it off. You can hold it off. You can even put it off. You say, I thought everything has a time. Yes, it does. You can speed it up. Or you can stretch it out. That's on you. You got a house. You got a car that you just bought, some of you. Nice car, huh? It's got a life expectancy to it. Doesn't it? Usually they don't think it's going to last beyond three, but they'll give you a note for five. Knowing that by the time you finish paying for it, it has died. But they give you a book of directions telling you how to upkeep your car so that you can stretch the days of life for your car. It's gonna die. I don't care if it's a Rolls Royce, a BMW, whatever fine car you like. When you get it out the storeroom, fresh, spanking new, smelling good, know that sooner or later, something is gonna happen. Time wears it down. Time wears it out. But if you are conscious that time is going to wear it out, then how do you extend the days, the life of your car? Certain things you have to do, and that's called maintenance. You got a beautiful home. The home is not going to keep itself up. You got to keep it up. And if you don't do the things to maintain the wellness of your home, then pretty soon the plumbing is going. The electricity is going. The pump is going. This is going. So your job, if you want to extend the life of what you got, is to maintain it properly. Put the right oil in. Do the right thing by your automobile, by your home. You got a fur coat, you're proud of it. It looked good the first day you got it. Check my mint. Ain't it bad? Yeah, it'll look bad, bad, bad if you don't take care of it. But you know how people are. They take care of something when it's new. But after it wears on them a little bit, they say, oh. Then you see them throw the mint. When they got the car, they drove it into the garage or they put a boot on it. it. It did something to make sure nobody would take it. After a while, they don't care no more. Just like a wife, you know? When you first marry, you can't get close enough. You're all in the seat. She's almost in your lap. But after a while, you see her slide more over to the door. And all of a sudden, she's got a position right next to the door like she's thinking about getting out. And you ain't saying, honey, come close. You're just driving down the street, no conversation at all. But when you was courting and just getting married, almost running into a car talking to the girl.
Right.
Your life. You take your own life for granted. You think you're young and you think you're going to live a long time. So you're careless with your life because you figure old folk die, but young people don't die. Check the funeral parlors out today. Still with young people getting away from here. Mothers burying their sons. Mothers burying their daughters. Grandmothers burying their grandchildren. When we thought as we got older, we would leave and build something for our children, then die and leave them with it. The children are dying, leaving the grandparents. We got some decisions to make. Allah says, I give life and I cause death. Well, what is life? And what is death? Let's see about these two things here. I'm alive, I believe, physically, and that's important. But if I'm not alive mentally and spiritually, I don't know how to protect the physical life. Because you have to be alive in every plane of your existence in order to protect the physical, which is the housing for your spiritual. If you lose intellectual life, mental life, spiritual life, then you start doing things that will end your physical life. You start eating the wrong food. You start hanging out in the wrong places. You start making the wrong choices. And then death comes. You're hardly able to marry and reproduce your own family line. You are wiped out before you get a chance. Life. What is life? Well, there are many, many definitions, but I'm going to deal with just a few. Now, I quoted the Quran. I'd like to go between Bible and Quran and life experience so that you know that whatever we say, brothers and sisters, if you're not hip to Bible, excuse the expression, hip to the Quran, you've been living, you're hip to life. And some of you have lived long enough to be real slick at life, but your slickness is killing you. So we have to give some directions so that you can maintain this that you have. That is the greatest, most precious gift that God could give, is the very life that you presently have. And you must do nothing that would destroy this precious gift that God has given. It will wear away in time, but your duty is to preserve it, to protect it, and to extend your days as long as you can. That's your duty. But in order to do that, you have to have knowledge to make right decisions for your life. Now, according to the scholars, when God created Adam, he breathed into him, and the book said he became a living soul. Now, the body without breath is dead. The body with breath is alive. There are vital functions that each living person has to engage in order to be considered alive. You have these wonderful systems that God has created, 9 of them, and the 10th one is the brain, the most undiscovered, unexplored, underdeveloped reality is the human brain. If you only knew how powerful God made you, if you only knew the value of your 9 systems, and most importantly, the value of your mind, your brain, then to preserve and protect this, that this can preserve and protect this, it is incumbent upon each human being to develop the mind. Somebody said a mind is a terrible thing to waste. You can't waste what you haven't developed. If you develop a mind, you'll never waste it. Mind is not brain. Mind is the sum total of your acquisition of knowledge, either by reading, by studying, and learning through life experience is what produces mind. Brain, you are given. Mind can expand. If the brain starts expanding, you got trouble. Somebody hit you in the head, and you get, the brain starts swelling. You might say, well, my mind is expanding. No, brother. Your head is in deep trouble. So sometimes the doctors have to go in and relieve the pressure, bring the swelling down. Brain should stay. It should grow. But when it grows to full capacity, you don't want brain to grow. You want mind to grow. And the expansion of mind can go 76 quintillion miles, meaning that the brain is capable of coming into contact with the universe of light. And not only coming in contact with it, but learning how to deal with it and master it. That's expansion of mind. The mind is able to pierce the wall of darkness that sunlight does not illuminate. But the mind can go beyond the limit of light and bring out of darkness new creations. Mind can do that. When God gave you brain, He gave you that which set you apart from everything else in creation, and He made you potentially the supreme being. I'm
going to
say it again.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
What did He make you? Potentially the supreme being.